Thank you. name is Meredith Michler-Bryant. I'm the director of the Duke University Wind Symphony, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to our concert this evening here in Baldwin Auditorium. The Duke Wind Symphony will perform the second half of the program tonight, and I'd love to welcome our guests here on stage. Please welcome the Sanderson High School Wind Ensemble with their conductor, Creighton Flowers.
Thank you. thank you very much. Just a quick word of thanks to Duke University and Verena, most of you, Brian, for having us here tonight. It's such a thrill to be able to come and play in such a nice hall and get a chance to get outside of Raleigh and experience all kinds of new things. And we really appreciate the chance to be here tonight. Thank you for coming and listening and supporting us. And we'll finish our last piece of our portion of the concert with the march called Whip and Spur.
Thank you.
I would like to welcome you to the second half of the concert. We just opened with Dream Machine by Katherine Bergman, and she's joining us via the live stream this evening. The concert title is also Dream Machine, and hopefully we'll take you into this dream world today without actually putting you to sleep. Talking about sleep, that is the next piece on our program. Sleep was composed by Eric Whitacre, originally for choir, but then he thought it would work really well for a wind ensemble, and it actually does. Please enjoy this chorale-like, beautiful piece titled
Sleep. evening, everyone. Our next two pieces are Holst's First Suite in E flat and Stephen Bryant's Sweet Dreams. Why two pieces, you ask? Well, these pieces form a study on how to achieve what we all dream of as college students. No, I'm not talking about getting into medical school or even about working at Goldman Sachs. I'm talking about taking one original idea and recycling it over and over again in different contexts to create four whole movements of material. And just to give away the secret, here's the theme you're about to hear again and again for the next 15 minutes. Okay, jokes aside, Holst's Suite is considered a highly innovative piece in the literature. In the early 20th century, large-scale symphonic works were predominantly still written for the orchestra. Holst brought the idea of a symphonic suite to the setting of a military band. And while parts of the piece are indeed marches, including a part of the first movement, Chaconne, that resembles a funeral march, and the whole third movement, which is aptly titled March, others are decidedly unmilitaristic, such as the whimsical second movement, Intermezzo. And also, remember, this concert is called Dream Machine. So Sweet Dreams is exactly what it says on the tin. Imagine listening to the Holst Suite and then falling asleep. Don't actually do that because I'll be watching. Sweet Dreams is what you might hear during your slumber. It's a smattering of the original melodic fragments dispersed in a world of dreamy, indistinct haze. So please enjoy and don't nod off to Gustav Holst's First Suite in E flat and Stephen Bryant's Sweet Dreams.
Thank you. In the great green room, there was a telephone and a red balloon and a picture of the cow jumping over the moon. And there were three
We've had quite a busy semester, and this is our fourth concert already. And I just want to take a moment to thank all my students here on stage for a wonderful semester. I also want to take a moment to recognize one student specifically. It is his last concert with the Wind Symphony. He's a senior, and a class conflict in the spring doesn't allow him to play with us. So in the spring, usually we have senior recognition, but I want to make sure he gets recognized this evening. His name is Bilva Sanaba, and he's our principal saxophonist. Bilva is graduating, to be expected, with distinction in computer science and chemistry. He's also finishing a minor in music. He plays ultimate frisbee, and he's also the social chair of a selective living group on campus. After graduation, he will work as a software engineer for Amazon. Bilva served in several leadership roles for the Wind Symphony. He was president, and now he's serving as social chair. And I want to thank you so much for your contribution, for all your work, for musicality. He has been principal saxophonist and section leader. So this applause is for you.
Just like to note that following this concert, there will be a reception in the downstairs floor of Fiddle. There will be refreshments served, so please stop by. So our last piece is titled Festive Overture. However, it isn't really an overture to anything. There wasn't any work after it. However, it is very festive, which is very appropriate, as Thanksgiving is right around the corner, and we're all looking forward to break. So the story of this is that there was a theater that was promoting the 37th anniversary of the October Revolution in 1954. And a few days before the concert, they realized they didn't have a piece to open this with. Now, this might be very familiar as procrastination. Now, so they quickly phoned up Dmitri Shostakovich and said, "We really need a piece in a few days. Could you help us?" And thus, he worked very hard, and in 3 days, managed to come up with Festive Overture. And we hope you enjoy it. Thank you.